Bring it down for Rev today. 877-532-5797 is the number to join us. I'm going to go straight to the phones because I see some people there that I'd love to have a conversation with, and they've been holding for quite some time. So let's go to the phones. Let's get it kicked off in Chevy Chase, Maryland. Listening on 1450 WOL, the one and only Miss Richardson on line four. Miss Richardson, you're keeping it real with Reverend Al, but you got Andre today.
Well, I tell you, you're a great substitute.
Well, thank you.
Well, anyway, Arnie, this is the thing. I want to go back to Father's Day a bit, but I just want to real quick, because I want to say both areas here real quick. We have to stop worrying about Donald Trump's having power now. You know, the Electoral College made its credit to him, offering him the position. Pre already knowing these things, they knew. All of them knew it. You know, they try to bamboozle the nation, which for a great deal they have, because so many people have bought into this man legitimately and legally becoming president. That's the tragedy in this nation, being deceived by wickedness and evil in high places. But this is the thing I want to say about Father's Day. We have to stop looking at that day that's supposed to be where we're supposed to only think in honor of our fathers. My father has long since gone, and so these things will happen. And for living fathers, God bless them, but we need to start thinking African also. We do not have an African conscience. Our conscience is Angloism. It has been pretty much programmed and conditioned into African-American people, especially us who's been here hundreds of years, being brainwashed and programmed and conditioned to be black Anglos. Because for the most part, sir, that is what we have become. Now, you may disagree, but that is the truth. The truth, the whole truth, and all the truth will set you free, however it says. And so that's the truth, Andre, even though a lot of blacks, even with your kind of an education level, and I'm not saying you, but many with your level of degree of education, they will disagree with me. And that's sad, because they have bought in blindly and without any brain power to not realize that they have been Angloized and set up. Now, Father's Day to me is a special day, along with Mother's Day. But you see, we have to start thinking of our African connection, how our true Africanism was. Because they believed in family, they believed in the Kwanzaa principles. You know, they believed in those things, and they didn't have time for a bunch of evil play. You know, the way that Anglo people do, white Anglo people, they're entrenched in it. They love it. They write books on it. All these things you can find out. It's right there. And so blacks don't go around writing books about how to kill people the way that the Paladin paper book did. I hate to say the name, but Paladin. And I think they tried to erase them off the scene. I don't even know where the Paladin is going now, but these people wrote this thing on how to murder, methods of murdering people. And all these things are done initially by evil Anglo people, Anglo white. So we've got to understand where the evil, really the input of it started. Colonialism in Africa, all that was there. But to make this short, because you got other people, I don't want to be greedy, is that we got to think of Father's Day as Africa Day, too, and Family Day every day. Every day should be our Father's Day. Every day should be Mom's Day. But we look at it the way Anglo people do, white Anglos. And Andre, you know I'm telling the truth. I'm an old woman now, but you know I'm telling the truth.
I'll tell you, Ms. Richardson, you know, when I think of the